With me on Skype this afternoon, I've got David Archer from Savannah Resources. David, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Andrew.
You're Skyping us from what you've described as the soon-to-be capital, lithium capital, in fact, of Europe, when Mina de Barroso comes on stream. Give us a little bit of a feel for what you've been up to over there at the moment.
Okay, yes, I'm here in Batikas, which is the nearest regional town to Mina de Barroso, and really been here showcasing the project to a series of journalists, investors, and brokers. Been here for the last 3 days or so, and I suppose the thing that sort of really occurred to me is it's a fascinating part of the world here. Really, the northern part of Portugal is, you know, very much the energy hub of Portugal. In the background, you can see the mountains behind me, and on top of that, there's a lot of wind generation from the windmills up there on the ridge, and there's an enormous amount of hydro development here in northern Portugal as well, within the immediate region. So the development of a lithium mine in this region is really consistent with that overall energy thematic that's sort of clearly playing out in this part of the world. So, you know, I think it's a really exciting region to be doing what we're doing.
And what's interest been like in the project itself, David?
Well, we're seeing it actually from a press perspective, mainstream press perspective. I think we're seeing a lot of unsolicited interest from European press agencies, and I think what they see is that you know, there's an enormous amount of demand, latent demand that's growing for lithium in Europe to power the EV industry, if you like, and they sort of see that having an indigenous source of lithium in Europe is a key strategic and competitive advantage. So they're really fascinated by the fact that within the boundaries of Europe, there's a sort of major new lithium mine development that's progressing here at Mina de Barroso near Batikas. So it's a big thematic, and I think it's one that'll only get bigger.
And a big day indeed for Savannah itself. Begun trading this morning on the Frankfurt Stock Exchange. Talk us through why you've decided to list here as a secondary listing.
Well, I think, you know, it's a sort of logical progression around that European thematic, and we sort of think that listing on the Frankfurt Stock Exchange will make it easier for European investors to invest in Savannah and indirectly invest in lithium in Europe. So it just makes it that little bit easier, and I think sort of really opens us up to investment interest, particularly out of Germany, I think German investors very much get the EV imperative, and I think they're very sort of keen to have opportunities to sort of participate in it from an investment point of view. So that's the idea behind the listing on Frankfurt today for Savannah.
You talk about making it easier for European investors. Have you currently got many European investors?
We have a few German investors, and we're sort of really looking to expand on that with the listing. So we'll be going out, you know, quite actively, both directly to the investment community and I suppose more broadly through the general press, particularly in France and Germany, to sort of highlight the fact that we're around and also sort of highlight, you know, our very exciting plans for Mina de Barroso. So, you know, we think that our story will sort of resonate with investors. And here's the opportunity for them to sort of develop an interest in the project through Savannah.
Might there be a Brexit element here? I mean, for when the UK leaves, could this serve as a safety net for you?
I think it can only sort of really help, although we don't sort of see Brexit as, you know, providing us with any sort of immediate challenges, at least to Savannah itself. A few little challenges around some of our European employees in London, but we can only sort of deal with that when there's some clear understanding as to what's actually going to happen.
And on the project itself, David, how's the feasibility study coming along?
Going very well, and our teams are working very constructively with the Primero team. We're building our team, our owners' team, both here in Portugal and London, and making very sort of good progress, both on the feasibility and, of course, making very strong progress on the ground. We've still got three drill rigs on site, two diamond rigs and one RC rig, and we keep on finding lots more of that white stuff. So long as we keep on finding the white stuff, we'll keep on drilling.
Very good, David. Nice to catch up. Thanks for your time.